In this video, we're going to show you through yet another related post plugin, which is a plugin for WordPress that very simply allows you to display lists of related posts across your WordPress website. I've got the plugin installed now and I've just activated it. And as you can see, one of the first things it does is ask you to fill out this survey. It's only a very quick five question survey, up to you if you want to do that. And then also you can choose if you'd like to submit usage data back to the developers of YARP in order to help them make improvements to the plugin. So I'm just going to click yes to opt in to that, and then it takes me to the YARP settings panel. Fortunately, the plugin works really well at default. You don't really need to do a great deal of modification to the default settings anyway. So we're just going to quickly go through that now. And the first setting area we see is the pool, and it just refers to the posts and pages and categories and tags that you would actually like to be shown. And in here, what we can see is the ability to disallow posts that belong to certain categories and tags from showing up. This is a large box that you can scroll through and make changes to as you see fit. The next setting, show password protected posts, is off by default. And that's because if you've got a password protected post, you probably don't want it to be in the related posts list, because then anyone clicking on it actually needs that password to view it. Then you can choose over what time period you want to show posts from. And at default, it isn't a feature that's turned on, but you can just turn that on with one click and choose the date range as you see fit. The next group of settings are known as the Relatedness Options, and it's just a way of configuring how the plugin manages how posts are related to one another. So the current threshold is set to 4, which is definitely fine to leave at the moment. And then what we can see is what we want to set these titles, bodies, categories, and tags to. So at the moment, it's just consider. You can choose to do not consider or choose to consider with extra weight. So for instance, if you had a lot of posts that had titles that were reasonably similar, or at least featured similar words, because your website is very specific, you may wish to choose consider with extra weight. And then the same applies for categories, tags, and bodies as well. Then you can see display results from all post types. And what this means is posts will only be ever shown as related to a post, and pages will only be ever shown to pages to be related. So you can turn that on if you would like, and then if you have pages and posts that are the same, they will come up as being related to one another. Finally, you've got show only previous posts. It's off by default, but if you turn it on, then say you've got a post published today, it will only ever show related posts for that post that came prior to it. And this brings us down to display options for your website. And as you can see, the one that's turned on here under automatically display related content from YARP basic on posts, it's already switched on. This means that on, say, single posts, it'll automatically display related posts at the end of the content. And as you can see, further to posts, you can activate this for pages and media as well, and indeed also display in the archives. Then you can just see you've got the maximum number of related posts. The default's set to 4, that's fine to leave it on. You can obviously change that to be less or more. And then we come down to how we want it to be displayed. So the default is list, and you can see the HTML is configurable here, as well as if you'd like to show the excerpt. And of course, if you'd like, you can choose thumbnails to be the way it's displayed with the appropriate settings for the heading, default image, and so on there. And then you can choose to write your own template for showing the related posts. We're just going to leave it on lists for now because that's the most common one, and we feel it's best fitting for this demonstration. Then you can just choose how the results are ordered. So you can choose this as by score, by title, by date, and so on. It's pretty straightforward. It doesn't really matter what you choose as long as you're happy with it and you know that you can change it at any time. You can also choose to help promote YARP as well if you'd like, just by clicking this link, and we'll turn that on so that you can see what that looks like. It'll just put a link at the bottom of the related posts area. And finally, you can also choose to display related posts in your RSS feeds. Turn that on or off if you want. It really depends on how you utilize RSS. But finally, when you've done making changes, if you've made any, make sure you hit save changes. That's where we're going to wind up this video now. So hopefully you've got an idea of the settings that are available in Get Another Related Post plugin and how you can change them and what those settings mean for your website. If you have any questions about what we've done, please feel free to ask in the comments below.